The commander of Australia's most lethal warship has been stood down after allegations of a drunken episode that caused international embarrassment for the Navy. Nine News can exclusively reveal the Defence Force has already spent 5 months investigating exactly what happened aboard HMAS Brisbane.
Kingsley Scarce, commanding officer of HMAS Brisbane.
A month after this interview, Kingsley Scarce was gone, relieved of his command of HMAS Brisbane following a formal complaint against him from within the Australian Defence Force. The senior officer accused of excessive alcohol use and causing embarrassment to Australia at an international event in front of US counterparts.
The commanding officer of a vessel must set the standard by which the crew operates.
I'm looking forward to showcasing what this ship can do.
In the lead-up to his replacement, HMAS Brisbane had been involved in Malabar, a joint naval exercise with US, Japanese and Indian forces, learning to operate together despite cultural differences.
Even something as simple as if I'm talking to some of my American colleagues and I say, do you want to go for a brew? I'm talking coffee, they're talking beer. So I'm happy with both outcomes.
Under Commander Scarce, HMAS Brisbane helped in the traumatic search and rescue operation off Queensland following a Taipan helicopter crash that killed four servicemen. He'd also commanded the warship in Talisman Sabre, a multinational military exercise involving 30,000 personnel and 13 nations. While not naming Commander Scarce, Defence confirmed a member had been stood down pending the outcome of an inquiry. There is no place for unacceptable behaviour or conduct within Defence, the department said. All allegations of unacceptable behaviour are taken very seriously and investigated thoroughly following due process.
Our Defence Force is extremely opaque, unnecessarily opaque. Defence needs to be open with the Australian public if they want to gain their confidence.
The investigation into Commander Scarce's alleged conduct remains active after 5 months. The speed and timing of his removal begs explanation, especially given Defence Minister Richard Marles' wider criticism that his department lacks in a culture of excellence. Andrew Probyn, Nine News.